sets you free. And I'm thanking you for doing exactly what a girl. Hi, everyone. I'd like you to meet Meghan. Meghan's the little cutie in the middle with a white t-shirt, beautiful smile. So look at Meghan, you think she's any other girl, and you'd be correct. She's 12, going on 13, just started 7th grade. All of her best friends seen here in her classes. She's got a little bit of a lisp, but, you know, most of her classmates have gotten used to it since she's had it ever since she could talk. And other than wishing she had a better iPhone to take better pictures so they wouldn't be quite so blurry for her scrapbook, she feels like she's living the life. That was until she met Trish. Trish is the new girl at the middle school. And Trish finds her lisp to be quite the topic of conversation. She loves to point it out to all of her friends at school. And she also has gotten into the habit of constantly reminding Meghan of just how embarrassing the lisp is via lots of social media apps, like with messages seen here. Meghan's not sure what to do. She doesn't want to unfriend Trish. Trish is so popular. Losing her as a friend will cause her to lose lots of other friends as well. So unfortunately, Meghan has become a statistic. She has fallen victim to cyberbullying. Cyberbullying, by definition, is the willful and vicious attack of people via technology, usually with social media sites like Snapchat, Instagram, Messenger, TikTok, all of which Trish uses to attack Meghan because of her lisp. It's sad because it's really affecting Meghan. Her friends are noticing a change in her. She's got weird mood swings. She tries to avoid her friends, activities she used to love, like going to the mall, hanging out. She suddenly doesn't want to use technology that she's always loved to use since she's grown up with it. And she's often super anxious when she receives texts or notifications on her phone, which are all typical signs of cyberbullying. But the bigger, more worrisome signs are she's sleeping a lot in class, when they're on the phone talking. She's starting to have reckless behavior. She goes out with random people, these older friends, older kids who seem cool but are up to no good. She's skipping school. She is losing weight. She never wants to eat. And also, she really, really seems to talk about death a lot. These are all not just signs of cyberbullying, but also huge red flags for suicide. But thankfully for Meghan, she has a good friend in Sarah. Sarah's the cutie seen in her BFF picture on her scrapbook in the pink tank top, which happens to be the tank top that Meghan helped Sarah pick out on one of their mini trips to the mall, which Meghan really doesn't do much anymore. So Sarah's worried. She turns to the internet for help. After looking up various websites on bullying and also the negative effects of possible suicide, Meghan decides she's going to reach out for help. She becomes yet another statistic to help save Meghan's life. Sarah, like 2 out of 3 students, is willing to step up to help defend her friend from cyberbullying, which is one of the most powerful defenses people who suffer from bullying can have. Sarah goes to Meghan's family, tells them about the worries that she has, and which results in them talking to Meghan, figuring out the problem and addressing it, and helping Meghan to escape the conflict with her cyberbully. But without her friend and the constant attention that she pays for her and the care and love she provides, Meghan could have been an even sadder statistic, like many of the teens who experience cyberbullying often consider suicide. 59% of teens experience cyberbullying, and most of them occur in middle school situations, just like Meghan is in. If you don't want your teens and your family members to become another statistic, the steps can be easy. Pay attention. Make sure if you notice signs that things are strange, things are different, they're not acting like they are, like they have been, talk to them. See if you can figure it out. Visit these various websites that offer lots of help and advice on bullying, suicide, signs, warnings, and things you can do. Or if you're not sure, call one of these various hotlines that can help. But remember, you don't need technology. pay attention to your friends, your family members, talk to a trusted adult, a parent, a teacher, if you attend church, a preacher, and just make sure you don't ignore it. Don't allow the statistics of teen cyberbullying and teen suicide